name is Maxime van den Broeke. I'm an account manager at Odoo. On a daily basis, I work with the implementation partners. Some of you might already know me. And actually, before we're going to start the topic of today, which is Odoo SH, specifically the functional features of Odoo SH and the benefits for you as a partner, I have an important announcement to make. You might have already heard about this, but Odoo is actually releasing a business game called Scale Up. And it's actually a card game which allows our users to learn to use our software in a very user-friendly and a fun and creative way. And a very positive thing actually about this is that you as a partner can get a free copy until the 15th of June. So make sure to check this out on our e-commerce website. And there you can order your free copy just until the 15th. If you do need any specific information regarding this, you can also find this on our website. So now let's get inside of the topic of today, which is Odoo SH. I just want to emphasize that this will be a functional talk and more a talk made for partners, which will explain you about the different functionalities, the different uses of this platform. But it's not really going to be developer oriented. Me personally, I'm not a developer, so I can't really help you with that. But there is actually a webinar available on our YouTube channel, on our official YouTube channel, which is fully developer oriented, and it's a webinar of more than 1 hour. So feel free to knock yourselves out if this is what you're looking for. But I hope you stick with me during this webinar so I can learn you a bit more about Odoo SH and what it can mean to you as a partner specifically. So let's get started. First of all, I want to go over the table of contents, so the different things that we're going to discuss, and the specific structure of this webinar. So first of all, I will be talking about the Odoo servicing models, specifically our SaaS or PaaS and our on-premise service model. After that, of course, we will be talking about Odoo SH, some of the general features that are available in Odoo SH, what you can actually do with Odoo SH. Next, I will do a small demonstration on Odoo SH. I will show you the platform live in action. Next, we'll be talking about the benefits. When I talk about benefits, I really mean the benefits for all parties involved. So all people that can actually make use of Odoo SH, all the benefits for those specific parties. And last but not least, we'll be talking about the pricing and also some additional points that I couldn't really get anywhere else in the presentation, but that are also very good and useful to know for you as a partner. So let's get started. First of all, we'll be talking about the Odoo servicing models. And for this specific topic, I would actually would like to request you to forget that Odoo SH has been created, that it exists. First, we're going to be comparing our SaaS servicing model to our on-premise servicing model, and then we'll actually see how this compares to the Odoo SH service model. So first of all, to compare SaaS with on-premise hosting, we can actually conclude that on our SaaS, if you are hosting your customer on a SaaS database on Odoo Online, that the initial setup has already been done for you. This means that you don't have to configure any firewall, you don't really have to install Odoo, you don't have to download Postgres, you don't have to configure any logs. So we do the initial setup for you, so you can easily get started. While on-premise, you will have to do the initial setup yourself, since you are going to install the software on a specific server, your server or the server of your customer. Next point is the ownership costs. And what we actually mean by this is the specific costs that you will have if you are about to host your customer on an own server. Then obviously you will have to rent a server, buy a server, and maintain that server yourself. While if you are hosting on our SaaS version, we actually take care of those ownership costs so that you will have no ownership costs to pay, which is of course a very nice benefit of the SaaS version. Next point that we want to express or explain is the open source aspect. So of course, as we all know, Odoo right now is kind of open core, the core being the community, which is completely free, and the enterprise version, which is the layer around it with the additional features and the additional services. Now, what we actually talk about with this open source point, we actually mean that if you are about to host your customer on a SaaS version on Odoo Online, you won't have access to the source code. It's still open core, but you won't have access to that source code. While if you host your customer on-premise, you will have access to the source code and you will be able to do developments. So as I just said already, the next point actually comes hand in hand with the previous point. Since you have the source code when you are hosting on-premise, you can actually easily do developments, you can modify the code, add additional features, etc. While on the SaaS version, you don't have the source code, so you have limited development of possibilities, or actually no development possibilities. If you do need customization on the SaaS version, we actually recommend using our Studio application, which allows you to add new fields, create custom applications, and that way you can do some developments, but via the Studio application, so it's not really development. The fifth point is actually the third-party applications, and this is also very coherent to the previous points, being that for on-premise hosting, you can actually install any third-party applications, while on the SaaS version, you cannot install any third-party applications. Now, you might be wondering, what do we mean by third-party applications? I don't know how advanced you are with the Odoo knowledge. Well, basically, on our website, if you browse to odoo.com/apps, you can find our app store. And this is not our enterprise applications. These are other applications developed by Odoo itself or by third parties, which can be downloaded for free or for a specific price. And these are applications that you can use in combination with Odoo Enterprise, if it's possible, depending on the hosted method, of course. And the last point is actually support. Well, so as you all know, every Odoo Enterprise customer has support from our side. So any customer can create as many functional related tickets or tickets regarding bugs on our website. If you browse to odoo.com/help, you can create as many tickets there as you want. So every customer does have support, but there is actually a difference, meaning that our SaaS customers actually have better and faster support, because if there would be a bug, let's just take a concrete case. If your customer experiences a specific bug, because the solution is hosted on our servers, we actually, with permission of the customer, we can access that solution, we can access that database and try to find out the problem. While if your customer is hosted on-premise, we will first need access to your server before we can actually have a look to the specific database and find the specific issue. So the support is kind of the same, but on our SaaS version or any cloud hosting service that we offer, the support might be relatively a bit more faster and a bit more smooth, so to say. Now, let's compare what Odoo Sage actually, how does Odoo Sage compares itself to these hosting options? Well, actually, it's very simple. If we were to remove the red crosses, then we actually get the solution Odoo Sage. So Odoo Sage is actually the one platform to rule them all. That's at least what we say internally, because Odoo Sage has all the advantages of both hosting methods that I just explained. Basically, what we say is that Odoo Sage is a development platform, but it's also a project management tool. It's also a great tool for your end user, and it's also a great testing tool. So actually, it's many of these things, and it actually offers all these advantages which we discussed in the previous slides. So if that isn't amazing, then I really don't know what is, in fact. Let's continue. Now, specifically, we've had a comparison between the servicing models and how Odoo Sage compares itself to the SaaS and the on-premise hosting. Now let's talk about Odoo Sage specifically and what the different functionalities are, what you can do with Odoo Sage. Well, first of all, an important point to mention is that Odoo Sage is fully integrated with GitHub, and this is actually a very powerful feature. Now, what this means is that you can connect to your platform, connect to your branch, connect to any database in real time. And it also means that every commit, every pull request, every merge or fork is immediately tested and deployed automatically. Now, I know that this might sound like Chinese to you, but don't worry, in the next couple of slides and during the demonstration, this should become a bit more clear what we actually mean by this. Now, also an additional feature which I already mentioned. So since Odoo Sage has all the benefits of the different hosting methods, it's possible to install third-party applications as well. And actually, as I will show during the demonstration, in our Odoo App Store, so odoo.com/apps, there you can find any application. And actually, for any application, you can deploy it on Odoo Sage, create a development branch in your project, apply that community module in just a couple of clicks. So it can be very powerful to install a community application in a very easy way in your database on Odoo Sage. Now, what's next? So imagine I want to set up my project in Odoo Sage. This will actually be the first screen that you get to see, the first screen that you get to encounter. And actually, what you see on this screen is, first of all, you have to select your repository. So do you want to create a new repository or do you want a repository with some existing modules? There you can actually choose the name of your project as well. You choose the Odoo version. So as you can see, you have to choose one of the last three versions. So version 12, version 11, or version 10. Next, you have to enter a subscription code. So this means it needs to be, if it's a customer, it needs to be a subscription code where the Odoo Sage product lines have been added so that they have access to Odoo Sage. If you are a partner and you just want to create some testing instances, you can enter your partnership reference code there to create a free trial instance on Odoo Sage. And last but not least, you can choose the hosting location. So it's not that you can choose in which country you want to be hosted, but you can choose on a more wider scale. So you can choose to be hosted in Americas, in Europe, or in Asia. So that's kind of it. That's how you set up your project in OdoSage. This will be the first screen that you encounter. Now, what's next? So if you see this specific screen, this is actually the first screen that you will see when you have set up your project. I want to emphasize a few buttons already on this screen, and those are these buttons. So first of all, you can see a clone button. What the clone button allows you to do, it allows you to copy a specific branch so that you can work locally. Next to that, you can see the fork button. The fork button allows you to clone a specific branch so that you can order new features, for example. Then you have the merge button. Well, what the merge button will do, it will merge two branches so that you can merge specific features and use those features in one specific branch. And the next button I want to explain as well is the submodule button. So as I already mentioned, you can create, you can install any third-party applications in OdoSage, and that you will do through this submodule button if you don't install it from the App Store directly. So if you would press this button, you can enter the repository of where the community module is located, and it will be installed in your OdoSage project. Now, what's next? So what's next? You see three stages at the left. You have the production stage, you have the staging stage, and you have the development stage. So let me explain you what these stages stand for. First of all, you have the production stage. In the production stage, there you will have your production database, the production database of yourself or the production database of your customer. So this is the database with their live data. This is the database which they use for their day-to-day operations. Next, you have the staging database and the staging stage. And in the staging stage, you can have a staging branch, which is actually a duplicate of your production branch. So it's a duplicate of your production branch. The production data is in there, and that's actually a stage you will use if you want to test a specific feature with the production data before actually applying this in your production database. And last but not least, we have the development stage. This is actually a stage where you have specific branches with demonstration data. And so if you were to install a community application, first it will create a development branch so that you can test that feature in the development branch with the development data. So that's regarding the specific stages. During the demonstration, I will go over them as well and see what you can do specifically with those stages as well. Now, what's next? So what you can see here is actually the OdoSage editor. And what this allows you to do, this actually is a developer feature which provides direct access to your code. So basically what you can do with this, or what your developer can do with this, you can access all the different databases on a code level. And you actually have the possibility to move, modify the custom code, but not the standard code. That's kind of the console, basic explanation. Now, what's next? It's actually the logs. And the logs is also something very important, something very useful. What you can see here are the ongoing logs of your current usage. And this is actually very good for your system administrator to troubleshoot specific problems. What happens in this log tab as well is that specific commits are actually tested automatically in the platform, and 1,000 tests are performed instantly on every commit. So this can actually save you a lot of time and a lot of time basically, which allows you to work faster eventually. What you can do as well, and what you can see on this specific page as well, is a filter button. So if, for example, in the logs, it appears that there's an error, you can actually filter on the error and find out where this error is coming from and then take action appropriately. All right, so last but not least, before the demonstration, I would like to show you the backups tab. And on this backups tab, you can see a few buttons already. So first of all, you have a button to import a specific database. Then you have a button to do a manual backup. So imagine you need to do a backup at a specific point in time. You can press this button. It will create a manual backup. And you have the possibility to download a dump of your production database. Now, you might wonder, okay, do I have to take manual backups all the time? No, that's not the case. So we also take automatic backups. If you need specific information regarding how many automatic backups we do, you can find this on our website. We have it in our documentation. But in general, when you go to this step, you will always have 7 daily backups available and 4 weekly backups available. So that's just a nice detail, a nice extra touch to the backup tab. Oh yeah, and another tip for partners is actually that OdoSage can be a very good upsell opportunity right now. I might explain this or elaborate on this with a specific example. Imagine you have a specific customer and currently they're hosted on their SaaS version on Odoo Online. but the customer is finding something which is not really possible in the SaaS version and requires some development. And actually, it might be a really good idea to migrate your customer to Odoo SH, which in general, the process should be relatively simple. And this actually allows you to start some developments or add some custom applications on that database. And that's not everything, because you as a partner, currently there's a promotion going on that you get 100% commission on every Odoo SH sale up to 150 euros per month. So you can actually have a very nice financial benefit of this as well. So now we're going to do a small demonstration. I'm going to show you Odoo SH in action. So let's get to my project. So as we can see here, we have my specific project that has been opened. And on the top right here, we can actually see my specific GitHub user. So this is my GitHub username. And as we can see here, we have a few specific buttons available as well. So you have an FAQ, you can contact the support. So this will bring you to the odoo.com/help website page. You can send a specific feedback regarding the platform. You can watch your GitHub profile and you can choose to log out. That's not really relevant at this point. Here you can actually see the name of my project and the different projects I have created. And of course, you also have the button to create a new project right here. Right here, you have the documentation. So we really have a lot of documentation on Odoo SH already. So feel free if you don't find anything or if you don't know exactly an answer or how to configure something, feel free to check out this documentation. It might be really helpful as well. Now, what I want to discuss next is actually the different buttons that I have already discussed. So as you can see, they are available here. So I'm not going to go too much in depth, but it's important to note that these buttons are available right here. And next you have our specific stages that I explained during the previous slide. And as you can see, I've already created a couple of databases. So as you can see, I have a production database, I have a staging database, and I have two development branches that are in the development stage. Now, what I would like to do is, first of all, I would like to show you how easy it is to install and build a development branch with a custom application from the App Store. And how I'm going to do that, I'm going to open our App Store. And as you can see, I've already searched for one specific application because this application should be very easy and fast to install. But as you can see, we have many different applications as well. So if I press the All button here, I go to all the applications, both free and paid applications, and I can implement or install any application that I would like to use. But now in this case, let's open this application and install it. So as you can see, as I explained, there's this deploy on Odoo SH button. So let's press it. And then I can select the specific project. I have opened this project. So I'm installing it in this project. And it will give me a specific warning because this module is actually targeted for Odoo 11. But in this case, it actually works for Odoo version 12. So let's just install it anyway. So as you can see, it's kind of starting the building process. And what we can see next is that it starts building a development branch for this specific application, which is exactly what we wanted. So I can check here and we can see that the build has been queued. So now it will take a couple of minutes before this development branch is ready with this custom application. Now, what I want to show you next is actually, because this is not a feature that I want to elaborate on, I've actually installed another feature already, which is in this development branch. And what I would like to do is show you this specific application. So first I'm going to connect to this development branch. So what this application actually does, it allows you to send WhatsApp messages straight from Odoo, straight from your Odoo CRM or straight from the contacts in Odoo. So it's a very powerful application. I found it very interesting. So I've already installed it for you. So if I go to my applications, I have to remove this filter because it's not an enterprise application. And then I enter WhatsApp. I will see that this custom third-party application has been installed in my development branch. So I've already installed it for you. Now let's also see that the specific function works. And I can actually easily see that by going to a contact. And as you can see here, there's a button available called WhatsApp message. In terms of the interface, there seems to be a small bug, but this can be fixed by the third party itself. So as you can see, if I press this message, I can send a specific message and it will be directly integrated with WhatsApp and it will send a message on the WhatsApp of this specific customer in this case, or a specific company. So the function works. So I'm happy I've tested this function in my development branch. Now what I will want to do, or what actually makes sense to do, now that I have tested this in my development branch, now I want to test this specific feature with my production data. So I'm going to test it in my staging branch. What I'm going to do is I'm going to make use of this function. And actually, I don't even have to press this button. I can just drag and drop my development branch to my staging branch to merge these two branches and to kind of merge these databases and use these features with the production data, which is already in my staging branch. So I'm going to merge this. Now, I can assume that this might take some time. So hopefully it will be ready once I'm done explaining you a few other useful features in OduSH. So let's first take a look at some other features. So it's obviously it's building. So in the meantime, I want to go to the settings. And what I can see here in the settings, first of all, I can rename my project. If I chose a wrong name, I can change the URL. So if I want another name, I can just rename this project right here. Now I can also add as many collaborators as I want. So I don't have to work on my own on this project. I can just add a collaborator. For example, someone from Odoo that I know his GitHub account. I will add Antoine Huvel as a collaborator of my project. So I will press the add button. And as we can see, he's been added as a collaborator. And I can also configure the access rights of this specific collaborator between admin or a user account. Now, what else do I want to discuss? First of all, there is this button here, which allows you to publish your development branches so that any visitor of your database can actually connect to the development branches. So that's an interesting feature. But this is actually a way more interesting feature. So I can imagine if you're managing a project and you are testing specific applications, you don't want to install every enterprise module time after time again. No, you might have an idea of a fixed set of modules that need to be installed right away. So that's what you can do here. So if I press install only my modules, I will have to manually install every application once I start a new development branch. I can do a full installation. I can install all modules. Obviously, this will reduce the building time. This will increase the building time. So it will take longer because there's more modules that need to be installed. Or you can select a list of modules. In this case, I've selected the CRM application. So for any new development branch that I create, the CRM application will be automatically installed as well. Now, what we see here are a bit more technical features. So here we see the sub-module. So that's kind of an overview of your community applications, third-party applications that are installed. And as we can see here, you can also have some statistics regarding your database. For example, the database size, the database workers, and the staging branches. So you can keep a close eye here on how many of these parameters are actually applied in your OduSH project at that time. But this is actually something that we'll discuss at the end of the presentation. So I'm kind of done on this page. I'm going to switch to the status page. And on this page, you could actually display or monitor the average uptime of our Odoo servers. So this is what you can see on this page. It seems to be loading kind of slowly right now. So I'm going to skip this part. What you can see on this page are actually, it's also a bit more technical, but here are actually the builds. And what you can see here is that, so this specific, application, third party application, which I just installed is still building. So that's what I can see here. And all the other builds I can see here are previous builds that I've made. So if it appears in green, that means the build has been successful. Now you might have noticed already that there's also a specific connect option here. So if I press connect, I will be immediately logged in the database as an admin user, most likely. Now, what you can also do is press the connect as button, which will allow you to connect as a different user. But I might get show that more in depth after this as well. So what I want to do now is get back to my branches and see if my staging branch has already been built correctly. And so I can see that the build has been correct. So the specific application has been merged with my production data. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to connect and I'm going to check whether this WhatsApp application has already been installed in this database. So let's check that out. I'm going to go to applications. Again, I'm going to remove the filter and I'm going to search for WhatsApp. So as you can see, we cannot find the WhatsApp module. And there's actually a very reasonable explanation for that, because what you first have to do is you have to enter the debug mode. There's multiple ways of doing this, but I always do it like this. You enter a question mark plus debug after the web, which allows you to go in debug mode, but you can also download an extension, which allows you to go in one click in debug mode, but I always do it like this. So I'm going to enter the debug mode and there will be a new button that appears, which is update applications list. So I'll press this button. I will press update. And normally, if everything has went well, then I should be able to see my new application in the database. And that's true. So I can see the WhatsApp application. It has been refreshed. So now I can install this application as well. So let's do that for a minute. It takes a few seconds. And so if I go to my contacts now, and this is my production data, so I don't have production data in my staging branch, but normally you would have a database full of your production data so you can test a feature on the production data. So as I can see here, the WhatsApp button has appeared. So what I will do now, I will close it down because I have tested the feature in my staging branch. So I'm satisfied. And what you would do now, you know that the feature works in your staging branch. So now what you could actually do is drag and drop your staging branch to the production branch so you can merge these together as well. So your staging branch will be merged with the production branch, which allows you to use the feature in the production database, in the live database of yourself or of your customer, depending on the project. So I can merge these as well. I'm not going to wait for that. So obviously it's going to merge these specific branches as well now in the production branch, which allows my new function feature to be installed in my production database. One more thing I have not shown yet, which is interesting as well. It's an interesting feature. So as we can see here, I went to a master development branch I have here left. So I showed you the connect option. I showed you the connect as option, but here you can specifically see that you can select the specific user that you can log in with on the database. And you might be wondering why this is useful. Well, actually, in a lot of cases in a company, you have to configure specific access rights depending on the department where your employee works in. So first you're going to configure, do all these configurations. And then afterwards, of course, you want to test whether you have configured it the proper way. So this actually gives you a very easy way to test whether the specific person has the proper access rights and can only see the specific fields that he should have access to. So that's what you do here. Last thing I would like to show is actually our mail catcher. And what this does, it catches all the mails so that you can actually also see the emails that have been sent in your specific branch and that you can optimize those emails as well. What I will do here, so I will actually show you in a very quick way. It doesn't take that much time. So I will connect to my development branch. It is connecting. And once I'm connected, I'm going to go to a contact. I'm going to go to the same company as I went to before. And here I'm going to send a message. So I'm going to send a message test. I will send the message. So we can see the message has appeared here. Now I will go back. I will go to my master branch, open the mails, and normally I should see here that the specific test has appeared. Let's quickly have another look. So as we can see here, the test has appeared. So this way I can see the specific email, see if I want to change anything of the template and test that as well. I can download the specific email or I can pop it out. So yeah, there's many features you can do, or there's many things you can do with this specific feature. In fact, that is everything for the demonstration. Let's continue regarding the next topic, which is actually, if I'm not mistaken, the specific benefits. So also something very interesting, of course, the different benefits involved to all partners involved in involved to all parties involved in such a project. So first of all, let's talk about some general benefits. So as I said before, a general benefit for OdoSH is actually that it provides the best of both worlds. So as we could see when we are comparing the SaaS version to the on-premise version, all the different advantages you had in both servicing models, every advantage is actually available in OdoSH, which reasonably explains why we say that it's the best of both worlds. Also, it has a very fast deployment time. So as you could see, I could easily install specific modules. My apologies. I could easily install specific modules. I could easily set up my first database for my prospect. So the deployment is really, really fast. Third point is actually the GitHub integration. So we've already discussed this. No reason to elaborate on that. And fourth point is, of course, the third-party application. So it's easy to deploy a third-party application in an OdoSH database in an OdoSH project. Now let's talk about some partner benefits, because obviously most of the people watching this webinar are normally partners. So let's talk of your specific benefits of making use of Odoo SH. So first of all, there's no hosting needed. So you don't need to buy or rent a specific server to actually install the database of your customer on that specific server. So there's no hosting needed. There's no maintenance of a specific server needed. There's no server management involved. So you don't need to have that technical knowledge on how to do that. So which is definitely a huge advantage for you as a partner. We take care of all the infrastructure, basically. Secondly, it's easy and fast to set up. So as I just shown you, you don't have to do any setup. As we said, you don't have to install a firewall. You don't have to configure the logs. You don't have to install Odoo at all. So it's really easy to set up. Next to that, we have all the SaaS benefits that actually apply, meaning you have a free migration. You have a fast migration, meaning you have updates. So that's the next point. Actually, you have in-between versions. So the big difference between an on-premise installation of Odoo Enterprise and or a SaaS or Odoo SH implementation is that on SaaS and Odoo SH, you actually have in-between versions. So I'm pretty sure that we have already released 12.1, version 12.1, version 12.2, which are already applied on the SaaS or on the Odoo SH, while for on-premise users, you will have to wait until the next big version, until the next release, which gets announced on the Odoo Experience. And last but not least, this is actually the main advantage for you to sell Odoo SH and to implement Odoo SH is the 100% commission promotion that is running right now. So you have 100% commission up to 150 euros per month, which can actually provide you a very good financial benefit, as this is also the actual cost. So the pricing that we apply for Odoo SH is the actual cost for Odoo itself. So the fact that you get 100% commission on these sales up to 150 euros per month is actually a beautiful advantage for you as a partner. Let's continue about the other benefits for other parties involved. We have the developers as well. So first of all, the developers can work on multiple devices. That's definitely a useful point. You can also directly test your development. So as we've shown, you can develop some features and you can instantly test those on a staging branch or on a development branch with demonstration data. And there's continuous GitHub integration. Next, there is the project manager. So the project manager, what's very good for them is that Odoo SH actually connects all the different teams. It allows you to monitor your progress in real time. So with the logs, you can check what's going on. It's very user friendly. And as we said as well, there's full and fast integration. What about the advantages for the end users? So first of all, there's easy testing possibilities. So you can easily test new features. There's fast support from the editor. So we are there to support those databases. And if there is a specific bug, with the permission of the customer, we could have a look in the database and see what's going on. And of course, there's cloud hosting. So of course, cloud hosting is very trendy right now. It offers a lot of benefits. So the fact that it is cloud hosting is actually very beneficial for our customers. And last but not least, we have the system administrator. So as we discussed with the logs, you can easily monitor your builds, your branches, and your commits. We take automatic backups or you take manual backups and you have the possibility to recover a database from those backups. So that's also a very interesting feature. And it's very easy to define problems and actually do some troubleshooting if you have specific issues based on those logs. You can actually define those issues and make sure you take the necessary action to solve those as fast as possible. So that's everything regarding the benefits. I hope that was clear. Last point, not the last point, is actually some other points that I couldn't fit in anywhere else in the presentation. Some of these points you might have already heard, but these points are actually good to know for you as a partner as well. So first of all, it's important to notice or to know that you can create an unlimited amount of SH instances on your project on Odoo SH. So there's no real limit. So if you need a lot of trial projects, a lot of trial databases, you can create as many as you want using your partnership code. Next to that, our customers, our end users need to have a subscription to access Odoo SH. So there's actually no demo trials allowed on Odoo SH. That's also very important to take into account. Another point is that there's full documentation available on Odoo SH on the website of Odoo SH itself. So we have very wide documentation, which can help you to configure the platform or to understand more about the different functionalities. If you have more in-depth questions regarding Odoo SH, there is always the possibility to acquire a partner pack. So we have dedicated support people that are ready to be assigned to such a pack and to help you with a specific configuration or an implementation on Odoo Sage. And the benefit of such a partner pack, of making use of such a partner pack, is actually that we can learn you how to use the platform, and then eventually you won't need our help anymore. Another important detail that I want to mention here is that a lot of partners think that when they buy a partner pack, it's actually cost for their own. But actually, when you are working on a specific project and you need that partner pack, you have the possibility to invoice these hours towards your customer. So eventually, it's the customers that pay for those partner pack, and you can learn from our dedicated consultants how to configure or implement a specific project via Odoo Sage. If you have questions regarding specific configurations, specific implementations, you can always send an email to pass@odoo.com. That's a general email address dedicated for the Odoo Sage team, and they will be happily happy to answer your specific questions regarding any configurations. And another detail, I've already mentioned this, but if you want to import a database on Odoo Sage, it has to be on version 10, version 11, or version 12. Another thing is project management in Odoo Sage. We've already discussed this quite a bit, but I want to emphasize it a bit more. So in project management, usually the people involved will be a project manager, a tester, a developer, and a system administrator. And the great thing about Odoo Sage is that actually it centralizes everything. So all the needs of each party involved, all the needs of these specific positions are actually answered within Odoo Sage. So all those people can collaborate in your project in Odoo Sage and solve specific matters or do their regular job on a project in the platform. A common issue for partners is actually also having a project managers and a project manager and developers, but no hosting and system administrator possibilities or knowledge regarding that. So the fact that Odoo Sage centralizes everything kind of solves that issue, or at least helps you to manage those processes as well. And last but not least, Odoo Sage is actually a very good way for partners to prepare demonstration databases, since you can create as many trial instances as you want, and it's easy to set up. You can definitely use Odoo Sage to prepare some demonstration databases and do a live demonstration for your customer. All right, and the final point is actually the specific pricing for Odoo Sage. Let's take a look to our website for that. So the pricing of Odoo Sage is actually configured based on three parameters. First of all, you have the number of workers. We actually refer to this as the number of CPUs as well. And basically what this defines is actually the number of concurrent requests that your server or the server that you're renting will be able to handle. So if you think you have only a few number of users and you would like to try it out to start with one worker, you can definitely do that. And if you notice that the server is becoming too slow, you always have the possibility to acquire more workers so that you can handle, or the server can handle, more concurrent requests at that time. The next point is actually storage. So that's the second parameter what the pricing is based on. And so depending on how large the production database of your customer grows, the pricing for Odoo Sage will increase or decrease. And last but not least, you have the staging environment. So as I showed you, we have a staging environment, which allows you to have staging branches in there, which allows you to test features based on the production data. So you can define for yourself how many staging environments or how many staging branches you want to have in that environment. And that will be that will increase or decrease the pricing as well. So now I was discussing the specific price for Odoo Sage for a shared database. So where you actually share space on a specific server. You do have the possibility to opt for a dedicated server, but as you can see, the pricing is actually $600 per month. So this is only for a very large customer cases with a ton of users, or a very specific reason why you need a dedicated server. But the option is there, and if you need a dedicated server, or you think your customer needs a dedicated server, you can definitely send an email to myself or to our PaaS team to ask for the specifics regarding this. So that's actually the main things about the pricing of Odoo Sage. And that's also the end of my presentation. I would like to thank you for your attention. If you do have any specific questions, don't hesitate to create a ticket via our support to contact me on my personal email address, mxv@odoo.com. I will be happy to answer all your questions, or to send an email to our platform as a service team at the email address pass@odoo.com. Thank you very much, and hopefully I will see you at the next webinar. Bye-bye. Q&A right now. So if there are any specific questions that need to be answered, I will have a look.
Let me check. I see a lot of chat messages. No real questions. I see one question regarding the business game. So the business game is called Scale Up. I'm sure you can Google it. Scale Up. Any questions regarding OODOO SH, the functionalities of OODOO SH? In general features of OODOO SH. I see some technical questions. Unfortunately, since I'm not available, I won't be able to answer those. If you do have a lot of technical questions, I recommend to send an email to pass@odoo.com. So pass@odoo.com, and they will definitely help you to answer those technical questions. Let me check for some functional questions. So I do see a question here. Is it possible to use Odoo Community with OODOO SH? So as I mentioned, OODOO SH is actually mostly meant for Odoo Enterprise, but you do have the possibility to install third-party applications, so community applications in your enterprise database. Has an option to import database in the backup. That's correct. Okay, that wasn't really a question. Apologies. Yeah, so Jackson, it's not possible to use the community with OODOO SH. So it's a platform designed, it's a hosting method, development platform designed for Odoo Enterprise, but you do have the possibility to install third-party applications and use those in combination with Odoo Enterprise. If I use OODOO SH as a partner for my own application, I still need to pay or can it be free? So that depends. Ahmed Brakat, if you want to use OODOO SH as a partner, if it's just for testing, you can create as many projects or instances on OODOO SH with your partnership code. But if you are talking about using OODOO SH on a production database, you will indeed have to pay for it. But the fact is that right now we have this 100% commission rule. So normally the hosting cost, you will have to buy Odoo Enterprise. You will have to pay for that. But the hosting cost that you normally have to pay for OODOO SH, that we will refund since we have a 100% commission up to €150 per month on OODOO SH. I hope that helped you answer your question. Okay. Yeah, drop the mic.
All right, so I see I dropped the microphone. That's my bad. Let me just answer a couple more questions which were asked regarding OODOO SH. So first of all, regarding using community on OODOO SH, OODOO SH is a platform meant for Odoo Enterprise, but you can use third-party applications together with OODOO SH combined, but you can't install community itself, Odoo Community itself on OODOO SH. So it's meant for Odoo Enterprise. Regarding a specific question I answered here. So if you want to use OODOO SH as a partner, so you guys can hear me, right? So if you want to use OODOO SH as a partner, and it's just for testing purpose, you can create as many instances as you want using the partnership code as an official partner, by the way. If you're a learning partner, you can use a production, your partnership code as well, but you can only create one instance. That's an important detail I forgot to mention. If you want to use it for production purpose, so your production database needs to run on OODOO SH and like it's your live database, then you will have to pay us initially. But since you have the 100% commission right now, the hosting costs for OODOO SH, so you will need an OODOO Enterprise subscription. You will need to pay for the enterprise applications. But we will refund you for the hosting cost as long as they don't exceed 150 euros per month. So that's an important detail as well. So I'm trying to look for, so guys, if you have any questions left, please ask them right now. So in the development stage, Jean-Marc, in the development stage, normally DB should not go to drop mode, but actually I would need to have to check this with some of our consultants of our AutoSH team. So I can't confirm this for sure, but that's my thoughts on it. And you should be able to restore a dropped production database. So that's an important notification since the production databases are being backed up. If it's a database which was in the staging stage or the development stage, they shouldn't drop normally. So guys, I hope it was a useful webinar and you have learned a lot regarding AutoSH and how you can use this platform to your benefit. If you still have any specific questions, I recommend to send me an email to my email address mxv@odoo.com and I will definitely be happy to answer them. If you have questions regarding specific configurations or very technical questions, the better solution would be to contact our dedicated platform as a service team at the email address paas@odoo.com. So that's paas@odoo.com. So again, I want to thank you for your attention. I hope this webinar was beneficial for you as a partner. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to drop me or our dedicated platform as a service team an email. Thank you very much and see you at the next webinar. Thank you. Bye-bye.